Boulder the dog is hard at work.
All right, Boulder, let's go. All right, Boulder, inside.
His job is an important one, and he takes it very seriously.
Sometimes he gets so excited, his feet get moving on a slippery surface just because he's so excited to do his job.
Boulder works as a guide dog for Leah Gerlach, who has low vision. The problem happened because she was born prematurely.
It's called retinopathy of prematurity. The retina stops developing and scar tissue forms.
So many babies that sometimes don't make full term. And as a result, sometimes their retinas, the film in the eye, doesn't develop right. She could not be corrected to 20/20 vision. She has low vision.
With my vision, I can see large objects. If I'm careful, I can read headlines on the newspapers. My visual field is about that wide. It's about 40 degrees. Sometimes I'm a little light sensitive.
Because of her condition, Leah had to learn to adapt. And that's where working with Dr. Tracy Williams comes in.
His focus is to help me find any kind of tools that might help me use the vision I have more effectively.
When you have low vision or you have any permanent vision loss, you need the co-management of the medical side of the fence and the rehab side of the fence. Despite having a vision loss, you're still here and you should be the best that you can possibly be.
Dr. Williams says a key part of that is being able to get around independently and safely.
You want them to have a life that's got independence with dignity. Safe travel is an important thing, and she should be able to travel alone.
That's where Boulder comes in.
Boulder's job is to help me move from place to place safely. He uses verbal commands given by me that he will attempt to complete. He will stop at curbs, steps, changes in grade. He will wait for a command. Basically, we have to develop a life bond with each other. I have to trust him, he has to trust me.
Leah says part of Boulder's training is to know when to not listen to her commands.
He makes decisions about safety if I'm crossing a street. I may listen and think, okay, I don't hear any traffic, but there's a Prius coming down the street, and he's gonna look and go, it's not safe to do that, and he's gonna disobey me.
Leah can go places that maybe she couldn't go before. The more options that you have, the more effective in society you can be.
Boulder's, he travels with me all over. He's good at, if I get lost, making me feel better. It's a sense of self-confidence when you travel with a dog.
Leah says Boulder's role in her life goes far beyond navigation.
Having a guide dog is so much more than just a work relationship. Dogs give you unconditional love. I can't emphasize enough that that's part of the whole bond that Boulder and I have.
Guide dogs, I think, offer a lot of qualities that we don't often think about. I think when the day's work is done, again, having that psychosocial companion, you know, the love, it's a great quality.
You've got a reason to get up on days when maybe you feel like, I don't want to get up.
Another quality that we should think about is crossing the bridge of acceptance. When you take on a guide dog, you are publicly admitting that you have a vision loss.
Boulder is Leah's third service dog after the other two retired. She says part of becoming a team with each is learning more about their personalities.
The relationship is very much as loving as it was with my other dogs, but very much different. Just like when you meet different people, your relationship with them may be the same. We love our children, but each of our children is different as well.
Having Boulder also helps Leah with her work counseling others with low vision.
They need to know that life goes on, and sometimes just seeing a working dog helps them know that, yeah, they can do that too.
Leah is a mentor to other people with vision loss. She's got a full life. She's got an independent life. She is not defined by her vision loss. She's defined by her head and heart.
It's a great sense of well-being knowing that you've got a dog beside you all the way. I can't think of life without him.